What is artificial intelligence? How the artificial intelligence will be applied in the world judiciary? And how our future robots will going to judge? Let us see. Artificial intelligence is the act of allowing a machine to behave in such a way that if any human being behaves. In 1956, John McCarthy invented the word artificial intelligence. And again, some people are of the view that mathematician Alan Turing's paper, Computing Machinery and Intelligence, which was published in 1950, along with Turing test, were instrumentalities which envisaged the goal of the artificial intelligence long, long ago. Artificial intelligence needs a lot of information or data to work. According to Julia, one of the creators of the digital assistant Siri, if a machine could recognize a cat with 95% certainty, it would be necessary to have the images of about 1 lakh cats. Artificial intelligence continues to influence every aspect of human civilization and society on a daily basis and will hopefully influence you more and more. Starting from machine learning, artificial intelligence has now entered into the field of deep learning, where artificial intelligence is showing the courage to touch human power and intelligence. As per venture capitalist Frank Chen, artificial intelligence is a set of algorithms and intelligence to try to mimic human intelligence. Machine learning is one of them, and deep learning is one of those machine learning techniques. Artificial intelligence continues to influence every aspect of human civilizations and society on a daily basis and will hopefully influence you more and more. The use of artificial intelligence, especially in developed countries around the world, has long since begun in the field of justice as in other fields. The judiciary has a great deal of effectiveness in administering justice in individual cases and presenting standards to society at large. However, regardless of the subject, the work of the courts and the judges is to process information which the plaintiff or defendant brings to the court, the information that is converted during the process, and the result that is also information or data. The word information or data are clearly defined in our Information Technology Act. Now we can see that in dealing with judicial cases, there is a huge need for processing information or with the help of information technology, and here lies the application of the complex algorithms which pave the way for the robust artificial intelligence system. Online dispute resolution can take the advantage of AI or artificial intelligence. Efficient AI system should have technical robustness and protections, privacy and information management, transparency, diversity, inequality and fairness, social and environmental welfare and responsibility. European Ethical Charter on the use of artificial intelligence in judicial systems and their environment provides a framework of principle on the use of AI which can guide policymakers, legislatures, and judicial professionals in their judicial work or related fields. Now, what is predictive justice? Predictive justice is the analysis of huge data on previous judicial findings which subsequently analyzed and processed by artificial intelligence as designed by its algorithm in predicting the decisions. Of course, in some special type of cases, not in all type of cases. Involvement of the artificial intelligence can be very helpful in providing advanced case law search engines, in online dispute resolution related cases, in providing assistance in drafting tasks, in different types of analysis, chatbots to provide legal assistance to litigant, and collecting various relevant data and making the same available for the judges or the legal professionals. Predictive trial software has been used experimentally in two courts conducted in 2017 at the initiative of the French Ministry of Justice in France. But the predictive model in the criminal offences have proved to be failure in most of the cases. In an applications of artificial intelligence in the United States, blacks were often classified as high risk, although they did not commit such crimes within 2 years of being convicted. Finally, see what is the scenario in India in case of applications of artificial intelligence in judicial work. In the above international situation, a landmark event took place in India a few months ago when the Supreme Court of India launched the Supreme Court portal for assistance in courts efficiency, which is also called SUPES for the Indian judiciary. SUPES is the Supreme Court portal for assistance in courts efficiency. As per the report in the media, its duty is to collect relevant information, including of course legal information, and making the same available to judges to quick justice dispensations, saving huge valuable time for the learned judges in a more efficient, cost-effective and time-bound way, but cautious enough, it is not meant to make a decision. If proven right, these AI system in our judicial system will definitely help solve the huge pendency of litigants in various cases in various courts in India. But there are another opinion with respect to this artificial intelligence application in the judiciary. They are of the view that this can increase the unemployment, and also they are apprehensive about the influence of artificial intelligence in the valuable judges' verdicts. Finally, a very important question remains in the mind of each of us, and that is whether one day the precious judgments of our esteemed court will be delivered or driven by artificial intelligence or deep learning or robots. Only the framer of algorithms, policymakers, and above all, time can answer.